Windsor. Imprisoned in Windsor, he recounteth his pleasure there past. By Henry Howard, Earl of Surrey. Read for LibriVox.org by Thomas Copeland. So cruel prison, how could betide, alas, as proud Windsor, where I in lust and joy with a king's son my childish years did pass, in greater feast than Priam's sons of Troy, where each sweet place returns a taste full sour. The large green courts where we were wont to rove with eyes upcast under the maiden's tower, and easy sighs such as folk draw in love. The stately seats, the ladies bright of hue, the dances short, long tales of great delight, with words and looks the tigers could but rue, when each of us did plead the other's right. The palm play, where, disported for the game with dazed eyes, oft we by gleams of love have missed the ball and caught sight of our dame, to bait her eyes, which kept the leads above. The gravelled ground, with sleeves tied on the helm, on foaming horse with swords and friendly hearts, with cheer as though one should another whelm, where we have fought and chased oft with darts, with silver drops the meads yet spread for Ruth, in active games of nimbleness and strength, her weeded strain, trained with swarms of youth our tender limbs, that yet shot up in length, the secret groves, which oft we made resound of pleasant plaint and of our lady's praise, recording oft what grace each one had found, what hope of speed, what dread of long delays. The wild forest, the clothed hopes with green, with reins of veiled and swift breathed horse, with cry of hounds and merry blasts between, where we did chase the fearful heart of force. The void walls eke that harbored us each night, wherewith, alas, revive within my breast the sweet accord, such sleeps as yet delight, the pleasant dreams, the quiet bed of rest, the secret thoughts imparted with such trust, the wanton talk, the diverse change of play, the friendship sworn, each promise kept so just, wherewith we passed the winter night away. And with this thought the blood forsakes the face, the tears berain my cheeks of deadly hue, the which, as soon as sobbing sighs, alas, upsuppered have, thus I my plaint renew. O place of bliss, renewer of my woes, give me account, where is my noble fear, whom in thy walls thou dost each night enclose to other lief but unto me most dear? Echo, alas, that doth my sorrow rue, returns thereto a hollow sound of plaint. Thus I, alone, where all my freedom grew, in prison pine with bondage and restraint, and with remembrance of the greater grief, to banish the less, I find my chief relief. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.